Charlie. No, it's not a pond. It kind of looks like one, but actually it's a wetland. And wetlands are more shallow than ponds usually. And they're places where water can runs off the landscape and then like maybe sits around for a while, and so that the water can be cleaned by the organisms that live in the soil or cleaned by the organisms that live in the water, and then very slowly drains down through the soil and leaves the property. The wetland has a lot of functions. It cleans water, so any soil that might be in the water, like let's say we had a really bad storm and some soil was traveling with the water from the ocean coming down the waterway. The wetland is a place where that soil can settle out. The wetland also has lots of, when it finally is finished, it's just been constructed now, so it doesn't look quite like it's going to look. It'll have cattails and all kinds of water-loving plants around it, and those plants will suck nutrients like nitrogen out of the water, and also if there's any farm chemicals or pollutants in the water, they'll suck it out. And then there will be lots of bacteria and microorganisms living in the soil around the wetland and around the roots of the plants. And they'll break down some of those nutrients and some of the pesticides that might be in the water, so that when the water finally leaves here, either by seeping down through the bottom or else running out through the pipe, it'll be clean. There are lots of kinds of creatures that live down here. We have five kinds of amphibians, so all five kinds of frogs and toads that live in Iowa have been found down here. We have salamanders. We have lots and lots of birds. We do have some voles too, I think. You'll see that there's prairie behind us, off this way, that's been there for 10 years, and I know there are voles living out there in that prairie. They would be very happy to live there. We're going to come out here probably the first or second week in January, one day when it's not too snowy and not too cold, so I don't freeze to death, and we're going to splatter native prairie seeds all over this area. And then in the spring, as the sun comes out and then it gets cold and the ground shrinks and swells and cracks form and things fall over, those prairie seeds will get planted, and next spring prairie plants will start to grow out here.